All countries will suffer the consequences of global policies of guaranteed failure. Fiscal imbalances, monetary stimulus, banker bailouts, and misallocated capital all destroy the economy of any country. Time is running out, and no nation can avoid massacre as all of the dominoes fall. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. We have to look around the world at each individual country and analyze it for what it is. Today we'll be discussing Brazil, and this is the 16 charts that prove Brazil is crashing. Let's get into it today as we see the basic facts for Brazil. This is out of the OECD's website. As we see, they have about 200 million in population, about 5% on their supposed unemployment rates, and their GDP is about 1% in the projected growth rate. So these are some basic facts for those who want to know. What I'd like to do here is cover these charts very quickly. I don't want to get into the detail of them. There really isn't the point of that. I just want to make this statement that even the BRIC nations, while they have excellent projected growth into the future, right now they're suffering just as the other nations are. Now, in the long term, we have great prospects for Brazil and the other BRIC nations. Absolutely. However, this is a global policy that has taken place. Let's look at this. We have three charts. We're going to go from the top left. And right here, the significant primary fiscal surplus deterioration. You can see that declining from 2011 down to what it is currently at about minus 1.0 on that percentage of GDP. That's just one example. Moving across to the right, rising gross general government debt. Every single nation is engaging in more deficit spending. What are they spending this on? Well, it is everything. That's military expenditures. That's all sorts of different things propping up certain factors within the government. And this is what happens. Every single nation is doing this. They all fudge the numbers as well. And Brazil is no different. Down to the bottom, double-digit twin current account and fiscal deficits. Current account balance, fiscal balance, all in decline. I believe there's another chart I'll show you in a moment showing you a different way of looking at this. But essentially, they're spending more than they're bringing in. What does that do? Well, of course, that's a ticking time bomb for when this all has to end. I'm going to move on to the next one. So we have a bunch of charts. I even have to scroll down here, but let's look top left corner. We're looking at this for their unfavorable growth and inflation mix and the favorable growth and inflation mix. A little difficult chart to look at here. Let's move on to the top right where we have this current account balance and the fiscal balance here. As we see, they're both in negative territory. Hard to read the font, but the current account balance -4.4%, fiscal is -7.9%. Both not very good at all. This is spelling danger. Very quickly, those type of numbers add up. Bottom left corner, formal job destroyed close to historical lows. And you can see, to me at least, it looks worse than where it was during the financial crisis. And what they're saying here is it's close to the historic lows. That is a very serious number. Next one over to the right, year to date job creation per sector. And we see that the services, civil construction, commerce, and processing industries are all doing terribly right now. Agriculture on the rise, but you can see that that isn't very good. They're suffering in that way. Moving over to the Brazil street protests are a key for the focus. We see that, unfortunately, they are enduring all sorts of violence in their streets. The riots are taking place, and this happens in every country, every major city, as I have predicted before. Whenever you have hardship, you have riots. The people will have their food riots because ultimately, when they're pushed to the edge, they will act in this way. I'm going to scroll down to the bottom. We're looking at the bottom left. Labor market deterioration pace, as we see it increasing significantly since the financial crisis, going back to where it was. This is a financial crisis part two. Moving over, confidence is nowhere to be reverted. The confidence is down in every single country. Look at what's happening in Europe. It's terrible right now. Brazil is no different. And then there are more charts here. I'm not going to get into this one, but you can look at it for yourself. Wrote about this in my book. What we had is the Latin American crisis, also the Asian crisis, but here we're talking about Latin American crisis. It was caused by massive amounts of government spending, leading to extreme deficits and high inflation. Doesn't that sound familiar for what we are experiencing today? And this happened to affect Brazil as one of those countries. But in the case of Mexico, the currency was practically destroyed in late 1994, whereby they devalued it, making its purchasing power reduced. And essentially what I mentioned here is that having a cheaper currency allowed Mexico to be more attractive for exports in order to boost the economy. I find that all countries are doing this in some way, shape, or form, trying to be more attractive for the exports. Look at what Switzerland did. They purposely did this, admitted to it in public. They buy up shares of their own stock market, admit that in public as well. They don't have to worry about that because they know that a devalued currency, while it shows weakness in a way, this is a topsy-turvy world. And essentially what it shows is that, hey, we're willing to go all the way. And the stock market sometimes goes up because of that. It's quite silly. This is right here, a longer and deeper depression than previously expected. Well, if you were tuning into the Money GPS, you would know that this is a recession, as they call it, a recession, that's going to go on for a lot longer than that. Well, of course, you can get the GDP numbers up. All you have to do is report fake numbers. I'm not sure why they aren't engaging in the same fraud that the US is, or even Europe. So thus, the real GDP declining significantly, surpassing 4% at that one point here. I don't believe any positivity coming out of these numbers, so I'm not sure why it's in the positive territory in this chart at the very last round there. We do not see a reversion of the negative primary balance. Once again, showing you that they're spending too much money and they're not making enough income, essentially. But they have a solution, but hang on to that for a moment. And on the right, even counting the fiscal measures approved this year, hike in tax for beverages and auto, hike in tax for gasoline, cosmetics, personal loans, corporate financial revenues, import goods, reversion in the payroll tax break, reversion in the exporters credit, hiking more taxes. And what happens? Well, it's not enough. It's never enough. That's the way this works. So let's move on to this here. Barclays, in fact, was the one to put out all this information. I should mention that. Gross debt to GDP is very likely to surpass 70% next year. Debt to GDP ratios are extreme. 70%, in fact, is low compared to what we've been seeing, particularly in Europe. Look at Japan. Look at the US. These numbers are astronomical, particularly in the Western nations that have so many of these Social Security and other things, the unfunded liabilities. When you really calculate that in, obviously it's much worse. Moving over to the right, placing Brazil among the emerging markets with the highest debt profile. Very, very big deal as we look at that. Hungary, obviously, in the news right now. Then we have Brazil, India, South Africa, Romania, and so on. And you can't have debt for so long. Debt eventually comes around to bite you in the behind. So you have a problem. The government reacts, providing a solution. What is that solution? Out of Reuters, Brazil needs a temporary tax increase to reduce a budget deficit that threatens the country's debt rating, the presidential chief of staff said in an interview published on Sunday. Wow, that is so wonderful. Always a solution to be provided. The solution is raise taxes. We need more money, so we're going to take it from the people. Sounds like a solution to me. We need to raise taxes, of course, temporarily, so we can, for example, open room for interest rates to drop faster. I say baloney to all of that. They say it's temporary. We never have a temporary tax. Never. How many taxes have we heard of? All we need to do is just pay off this thing and that's it. We're going to get rid of that tax. And it never happens. In fact, the tax continues to increase because they're gluttons. That's what they do. They consume more and more and more. A tax hike would help the government avoid $30 billion of a deficit, that's $7.9 billion, penciled in next year's budget. Other measures should include passing bills to reduce the earmarked expenditures and simplify sales taxes. They say simplify, I say increase. What we have here is no different than any of the countries. They're all increasing taxation. They're all increasing their inflation, whether they like it or not, engaging in QE-type measures. They're all basically robbing from the middle class and creating a chasm or a divide in between the rich and the poor. We are seeing the rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer. Very common thread seen all throughout history. This happens in every empire. The empire is falling right now, and as a result, there is a ripple effect throughout other economies. We have a nation like Brazil who is suffering along with all of those other ones. And yes, Brazil may do much better than, let's say, the US or let's say Greece or what have you. But it doesn't matter because all of the dominoes will fall. You can't have major nations, most of the nations, let's say, doing bad, and a country like Brazil on its own doing well. It doesn't work like that. They all need to work together now because of globalization. This is what concerns me. I hope it does you too. We need to really keep looking into this as the BRIC nations really do have a bright future ahead, but not without a bumpy road along the way. If you found this video informative, please give me a thumbs up. This video is part of my Global Economic Collapse series where I highlight specific countries along the way. We can't always talk about the US, of course. Many people from all over the world have asked me to do videos about their particular nation, so this happens to be one of those. So check that out on my main YouTube channel page for your country, always adding new ones in there, of course. Last but not least, if you found this video informative, I know you'll find my book, The Money GPS, even more informative. You can actually flip through the book. If you go over to Amazon, they have this look inside feature, which allows you to flip through the pages of the book and see if you like it. Take care.